So here we go, and my story is nothing so special, but I feel it will be a very historic moment for me to share my journey for you all. I was a dancer. Up to my 5 years, I used to dance, and I used to imitate all the steps seen on the TV and to copy the dance steps. Then one day, doctors told my parents, please tell Kaustuv not to dance, because dancing is not for him. That's the first time I come to know that I'm different. Although it was very small age to understand the disease, but I accepted it. I should not dance. So after restricting myself from dancing in the age of 5, I thought to do something by staying on a safe zone, because by then I was realizing that my bones are just like glass. Osteogenesis imperfecta is the reason for this. I'm having this disease. And you know, because of that, till now more than 50 fractures happened to my body. So I thought to do something else other than dancing so that I could avoid more fractures. So I took up singing, because my mother, Sheila Dasgupta, is a great singer, and I used to see that she is teaching classes in my home. So I took singing to express my emotions. My childhood was so, you can say it's crazy, but for me it was so memorable, because every day and every now and then there used to be a fracture in my childhood. My friends, my relatives, all of them used to define me as suffering. That Sai Kaustuv is coming where suffering will be there. So it is true that, 100% it is true that I am not able to do all the things because I am 90% disabled. But I believe being born with some sort of disabilities or some sort of difficulties that don't make me a disabled person. Because I have proved my excellence in so many other fields, what you all can't do. So I always believe that don't judge any differently abled person. Please don't judge, because you don't know that what we can achieve. So please give us a chance to show you all that what we can do. You know, after that, when I confined myself in small room, life gave me so many lessons. From 2009 to 2015, I was confined to a small bed and a small room because I could not move myself an inch. I used to be depressed all the time because I had to discontinue my study, I had to discontinue my music. Everywhere there was darkness. And my life was just on a pause. Then one of my friends came to me and they said that, Kaustuv, why don't you design and make your life so colorful? I just like to tell that my life was just like the Inclusion Summit logo. It is a black tree, and I put the colors of graphics on that, like the bars, and made my life colorful. So then I started learning designing. It was a very strong barrier, but I broke that also. Then slowly, slowly, I was expanding in that skill, and I used to design for all the people. You know, in some parts of our life, we need to see on what we can do. So only one finger of my left hand used to work that time, and with that I started designing. None of other parts of my body was working, so only with left hand, with one finger, I used to hold the mouse and started designing. Now I have global clients all over the world. So I feel this is something which always see the positive side of life, and because all other people, what they can't do, for me it is very much possible, because I never entertained the word no. After confinement of 6 years in a small bed, when I came out of the world in this wheelchair, I saw myself as a very different person. That moment I could not expect a miracle to stand me again. I could not expect to be operated because my bones are not strong enough to be get operated. I could not expect that to be furthermore confined in the small corner of the room and people should come to me and talk with me with sympathy. I don't like that. So what I did at that moment, I accepted myself in wheelchair. And I believe acceptance is very much huge than the expectation and made life, my life a miracle. I really feel very sad for the people who always complain. I really feel bad for the people who always blame society, their friends, their relatives, that they are not excelling in their life. They are not having enough opportunities to excel. I really feel pity for them because they feel they are caged in a our society and belief system. So if they are caged, then what am I? I need 24 into 7 to be shipped in a bed, to shipped in a wheelchair. I can undoubtedly say that I am caged. But I am not caged. I am above this body. I gone beyond this body. Because, you know, to make it more simple, when I get thirsty, if my parents are outside home, I need to be thirsty for hours because I can't get one glass of water on my own. So I can tell that I am caged. But I am a fly. I am flying in the sky with my determination, willpower, just like this inclusion logo, the birds. We are the real birds. This wheelchair can't cage us because it is the power. It is the strength for us. So I feel that I would like to say that be inspirational. Be motivated always. And don't think what you are, who you are, how much capable or incapable you think you are. Just keep aside your suffering, your problems and your anxieties and do something good what you can. Life gave me two options. To confine into a small room for 6 years with all the wonderful comfort of the world. And another option was to come out of the room and show the world what a 90% disabled wheelchair warrior can do. I chose the second option. Because I believe life is a celebration. We need to celebrate each and every moment, just like we are celebrating this summit. Before I conclude, I'd like to say very favorite formula of 4 S. First S is suffering. We all have suffering, not only the people like us in wheelchair. We all have suffering. So first S is suffering, and make all of your suffering today your surprises, because suffering don't come to you with invitation. So make them your surprises, and this surprise is the second S, and that surprises will make you smile. And the smile is the uniqueness of Sai Kaustuv. So whenever you are in suffering, look at Sai Kaustuv and smile. Please have a smile, because it doesn't cost you money. If I can smile, who's stopping you? Please have a smile. And, you know, always I feel that we have so many things in this world to do. So just be yourself, be motivated, be alive. And now I have chose my smile and kicked out my suffering. After today, this wonderful summit, you need to choose what, suffering or smile. You need to choose wisely. So it is on your hand to choose. Choose wisely. And before I go out of this stage, I would like to sing 4 lines of my own composition. So I feel that we love this. So can I have a track, please? Please close your eyes and feel the glow of in your heart, the glow of love and light, the glow of positivity, the glow of inclusion. In the silent night, stars are shining bright. We can see thy holy light in everybody's heart. Oh, in the silent night, stars are shining bright. We can see thy holy light in it. thy holy night, every moment, day and night, every soul will fill thy light, thy love and light. Sing thy glory to praise the Lord. Sing thy story to spread His love. Sing thy glory to be thy light, to fill thy light. Sing thy glory to praise the Lord. Sing thy story to spread His love. Sing thy glory to be thy light, to fill thy light. In the silent night, thank you so much. This is the real strength. This is the real strength what made Sai Kaustuv today strong and successful. You all are my strength, so be with me always as my strength. There is no existence of Sai Kaustuv without you. So one more S I'm going to add after 4 S, that is the strength of you all. Thank you so much. Thank you.